So B&M basically ruled the looping coaster business for the better part of two decades. And while it may not be dominating the market as it once did, the company's inverts, floorless, and dive models have specifically molded parks lineups across the world and especially in the US. Today, I want to break down their floorless coaster model, specifically by how many elements are packed in without as much filler track. So here is a coaster breakdown of the B&M floorless coasters in the US. First things first, a big shout out to Airtime Thrills for his incredible By the Numbers series that really sparked this idea, so go check out his channel if you haven't. It's easily one of the best to be doing it right now in the community. Now you'll hear me say things like prime ride track referring to his system really. So this ranking is all the floorless models in the US ranked from most to least feet per inversion. Now of course things like speed come into play, so I went through and got those stats as well. Now I removed the dead track that is found on lift, station, and brake runs to keep it fair amongst the model. In 11th place is my least favorite B&M, Firebird at Six Flags America. Now the first of three stand-up conversions, it only features two inversions over 2,355 feet of prime ride track. That's good for an inversion every 1,178 feet. Now additionally, it comes in 9th out of 11th for pacing, with only 45 feet per second. The ride itself is shaky, you know, it's a relocation and a conversion. And as the original B&M, it really shows its age and its design and its ride experience. It's slow and just too spaced out. Coming in at 10th place is Rougarou, Cedar Point's much larger stand-up conversion. Now with three inversions over 3,133 feet of prime ride track, it only gives one inversion every 1,044 feet or so. Now this is the last ride that eclipses that 1,000 per mark, and it has the saving grace of at least being 7th in pacing with 51 feet per second. Now most of but two of these coasters fall between 58 and 54 feet per second, so to say that B&M kept them consistent is a little bit of an understatement. However, this ride is just fine. It's much more memorable in a smaller park, but here it just seems to be forgotten. Now, it's a bit shaky, but it was definitely meant to be a stand-up, and I still think it's a decent ride. Ninth place is home to the shortest in length, slowest in speed, and tied for least inversions. Patriot at California's Great America leaves a lot to be desired. The two inversions over the mini 1,398 feet of prime ride track for a rate of 1 per 699 is much improved to the previous two, but this stand-up conversion just doesn't have the pacing numbers. It's downright embarrassing. It takes 40 seconds to complete the course, drop to brakes for a horrible 35 feet per second, which is 10 feet per second behind the next closest. Now, I don't know how good the ride experience it is per se, but for Patriot, it doesn't seem like it could go that high on any overall list. From shortest to longest, we have Dominator at King's Dominion. Now, the first true floorless coaster that not a conversion on this list has more track than any of its kind, including 3,393 feet of prime ride track. The issue here is only having 5 inversions when most of these large-scale floorless coasters have 7. At 679 feet per inversion, it barely tops Patriot. Now, that being said, Dominator has a little bit of an advantage by having those non-inverting elements pop a little bit more than others, but it finishes up at 3rd place in pacing at 54 seconds as well. Now, that's not a great distance from 8th place, but any bit helps here. Personally, this is the second best floorless I've experienced, so it's maybe a little better than the inversions count. Now, moving down south to Six Flags Fiesta Texas, we have one of the consensus picks for a top-tier floorless coaster, and Superman Krypton Coaster. Its 50 feet per second is one of the slower paces at 8th place, but rocking a solid 6 inversions over 3,226 feet of track is nothing really to scoff at. More action and less length than Dominator, and with the quarry wall used in its layout, it really is a gem of the model. It hits an inversion every 538 feet on average, and its pacing would probably be one of the best if not for those quarry climbs. Kraken, the monster from SeaWorld Orlando, slides in here at number 6, rocking 7 inversions over 3,375 feet of track. That's the second most prime ride track. This coaster flips its riders every 482 feet. However, where this coaster really shines is that 56 feet per second pacing number, good for second on the list. Now, the hot Orlando sun probably helps, and you'll see that later on with another floorless, but still, the trains seem to fly through a large set of inversions and trenches that probably keep the speed of the ride going throughout. Now, I really can't wait to finally tackle this beast come January. It looks to be one of the better floorless coasters out there. Rounding out the top 5 is the original floorless coaster, Bizarro at Great Adventure. Once Medusa, this ride flips guests 7 times, and 3,183 feet of ride track, good for 455 feet per inversion. Now, Bizarro also lands 5th in pacing at 53 feet. Can you tell how close these are really all paced? It's pretty crazy. This is one of my first and remains my favorite Floorless coaster, mostly due to the added theming elements that tend to spice it up with what has become a bit of an unoriginal layout. Now it's always a walk-on and it has some aging feels here and there, but it's still just a really fun experience overall. Now, speaking of unoriginal, we head over to the mirrored clone of Bizarro at Magic Mountain, Scream. Now, Scream is the exact layout flipped, but it gets the edge overall here because unlike Bizarro, it actually tops the chart in pacing at 58 feet per second. Most likely due to the California heat warming up the track, all of these pacing numbers are very dependent on when and where the POVs were taken. I tried two for the most part to get a bit of an average, and Scream just seems to haul through its layout more than most Floorless coasters. I mean, it's still a parking lot coaster to the max with no theming, so I don't know how much I can save it over Bizarro. Staying out in California but moving north to Discovery Kingdom, we have Medusa, also featuring 7 inversion and a slightly shorter 3,153 feet of ride track. Now this only beats out the former clones by about 5 feet per inversion, for a total of 450 feet per inversion. Now this coaster features a rare sea serpent roll, a straight drop out of Floorless, and it seems to be one of the more unique of the model out there, but it still only falls middle of the pack with 53 feet per second for its pacing. Outside of one of my favorite color schemes, this ride just seems good from top to bottom, and I think I need to get out to Cali to ride the only 3 of the 5 Floorless coasters I'm missing left. Number 2 is a bit of a dark horse pick for me in Batman the Dark Knight from Six Flags New England. Now it feels like the best paced Floorless coaster for me. It sits at only 54 feet per second, which is good for 4th, but it feels a lot faster mostly because it mixes in such a short prime length of 2,142 feet and 5 inversions. That's all the way down to 428 feet per inversion, which just feels like it doesn't stop until you finally slam into those brakes. If it was any longer with maybe a 6th inversion, it would probably be my favorite, but it just doesn't give quite enough length to edge out rides like Bizarro and Dominator on my overall list. Finally, the top spot belongs to Dorney's quirky coaster, Hydra the Revenge. 7 inversions and 2,688 feet of prime length, it is the easy shortest of the 7 inversion coasters. However, due to the JoJo roll from the station, it only ranks in at 45 feet per second in pacing, which is good for 10th, and far below average. However, if the JoJo roll is removed from the coaster, the pacing jumps right up to average at 54 feet per second, and the inversion per is still 404 feet, which is easily in first either way. So surprisingly, this may be the pick for the best paced Floorless coaster in the US. Personally, I really enjoyed this ride. It felt a little quirky and a little shaky here and there, but very unique for the model. Now, overall, my biggest takeaway from this deep dive for me is just how consistent B&M had these running. They seemed to scale their heights and speed directly to the length and the elements, as really only 2 rides fell out of the 8 feet per second range. Now, if you take out Hydra's JoJo roll, that just adds to the count. Throw in that many of these layouts feature the same set of inversions and the complaint that B&M made repetitive coasters, it really seems to start to hold some weight. But to be fair, even in my rankings, the coasters tend to jumble together a bit, with my top 4 falling at 42, 43, 45, and 54 respectively. Now that being said, almost all these rides have something that set them apart a little bit. A JoJo roll, a sea serpent roll, theming elements, or environmental locations. But which of these rides do you prefer, and did any of these numbers really surprise you? Hydra being the runaway leader in feet per inversion really shocked me, to be honest. Now, for more content, make sure you like, subscribe, and hit up some of the playlist, and make sure you go check out Airtime Thrills for some true A+ content. Now, until next week, that's all from the shores of Island Coasters.